أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم.
يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون.
أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. We give thanks to Almighty Allah and we seek His blessing of Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. The peace of Allah be upon him. On today's episode, we'll continue from where we stopped yesterday on the topic, conditions of acceptance of prayer. Yesterday, we discussed some of the points under the conditions of acceptance of prayer. Today, we'll continue from the fifth point, and that is, you should ask Allah in a good and honorable manner. And this can be found in the hadith of Prophet Islam, narrated by Anas bin Malik. And this hadith is found in Sahih Muslim. And Anas, qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, إِذَا دَعَا أَحَدُكُمْ فَلْيَعْزِمْ فِي الدُّعَاهِ وَلَا يَكُلْ أَلَّهُمَّ إِنْ شِئْتَ فَأْتِنِي وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا مُسْتَقْرِهَ لَهُ. This means that Anas reported Allah's Messenger saying that when one of you makes supplication, he should supplicate with a will and should not say, O Allah, confer upon me if you like, for there is none to coerce Allah. Now this means whenever we are begging Allah for something, you should ask humbly. Don't say, Allah, if you like, give me. If you like, don't give me. No, don't ask Allah in that way. You should ask Allah humbly. When you ask Allah humbly, like an humble servant, then Allah will surely answer your prayer. And if you see the way the prophets and the people of God, the way they do ask Allah, they do pray to Allah, they pray to Allah humbly. They don't pray with arrogance. They pray humbly and they have firm faith that Allah will surely answer that prayer. So this is what Prophet is telling us here. As at Imam Mahdi alayhi salatu wasalam, as at Mirza Ghulam Ahmad, the holy founder of Ahmadiyya, he said in one of his Arabic qasida, which is poem, he said that, فَمَنْ جَاهَهُ ذُلًّا لِتَعْزِيمِ شَأْنِهِ فَيُؤْتَوْ لَهُ فِي حَضْرَةِ الْقُدْسِ سُدَدًا. This means that he who comes to Allah humbly, exalting the greatness of Allah, he would surely be granted his request in the threshold of his holiness, and that is Allah. So Prophet Muhammad is telling us here that if you are asking God, you should ask Allah humbly, and you should ask Allah like an humble servant. By the time you apply this method when you are praying to Allah, then surely Allah will surely accept your prayer. And now the sixth point under the conditions of acceptance of prayer is that when you pray to Allah in some special periods, these special periods, we have narrations, we have hadiths, we have verse of Holy Quran that tells us some period that Allah do accept prayer during those periods. For example, during sajda, when you are praying and you are in sajda, sajda means when you prostrate during prayer. So during that time, Prophet ﷺ said, a servant is very near to Allah in that posture. So that means if you have something that is paining you, you want to ask something from Allah, then whenever you are praying, you should pray fervently when you are in the sajda. Another time is during the later part of the night, and this can be found in Holy Quran also, and that is talking about tahajjud. In the hadith of Islam, Prophet ﷺ said that a servant of Allah that wakes up in the midnight when others are sleeping, when that servant of Allah asks anything from Allah, then Allah will surely give him, because he is praying to Allah when others are sleeping. It means the pain of what he's asking from Allah, that thing is very important to him. And because of that reason, the time of tahajjud is very important. And that is why as a Muslim, if you have a problem, you should pray to Allah through tahajjud. And that's why Prophet Islam, and in front of Musa, he said in some of his sayings, that if there is a night between him and a problem, then he believed that that problem will be solved. This means during the midnight, during the time of the Tahajjud prayer, when you ask Allah things, Allah will surely answer your prayer. Then another time is during the month of Ramadan. And that is the period we are now, this month of acceptance of prayer. There are a lot of opportunities, there are a lot of ways that we can get acceptance of prayer during this month. When you fast, you are obeying Allah. Then by doing that, when you pray to Allah, Allah will surely answer your prayer. And also, during any worship or during any jihad, when you are striving in the cause of Allah, when I say jihad, I mean striving in the cause of Allah. Anything you do in the way of Allah, just to serve Allah, those things, when you are doing those things, you can pray to Allah during that time. Allah will surely answer your prayer. So these are very important things that we should note whenever we want to pray to Almighty Allah. Then the seventh point is that another secret of acceptance of prayer is by starting the prayer with praises of Allah, bitahmidillah, and also by seeking blessings on Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And this can be found in an hadith of Prophet sallam. He's reported to have said that إذا صلى أحدكم فليبدأ بتحميد ربه سبحانه والثناء عليه ثم يصلي على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ثم يده بعد ما شاء. When any one of you want to pray and want to supplicate, let him praise Allah first, then glorify him in the beginning, and then he should supplicate to Allah, and he should seek blessing of Prophet Muhammad sallam, then he should ask for what he wants after that. And that is why the best way of praying is by starting with the Surah Al-Fatiha, then you do Darud, you say Salatu ala Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, then you should ask for what you want. If you do this, it is a secret of acceptance of prayer. And now coming to what Asa Masim Baud said about the wisdom about acceptance of prayer. He said in Barakatul Dua, page 21 to 22, one should also remember that humility and anguish alone is not enough for prayer to be accepted. For it also requires righteousness, purity, truthfulness, and perfect certainty, perfect love, and perfect attention. Moreover, it is also essential that the object prayed for should not be opposed to the divine scheme of things and should not be against the welfare of the supplicant or the one on whose behalf we praise, both in this world and the hereafter. If it often happens that although all other conditions of the supplicant have been fulfilled, the object prayed for happens to be against the divine scheme of the things with regard to the supplicant, no good can come of granting such a prayer. For example, if a dear child of a mother should cry and beg her to hand it a burning brand or a snake, or to feed it a poison which seems agreeable, the mother would never fulfill such a wish. Were she to do so, even if the child were to escape with its life and were to lose one of its limbs, it should certainly grow up with a strong grievance against the foolish mother. Now, the point here is that sometimes we pray to Allah and our prayers are not accepted. And the reason for this is that maybe that thing is dangerous for us. And this can be found in Holy Quran also, in Surah Al-Baqarah, verse 2 and 17. Allah says, وَعَسَىٰ أَن تَكْرَهُ شَيْئًا وَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ وَعَسَىٰ أَن تُحِبُّوا شَيْئًا وَهُوَ شَرٌّ لَكُمْ وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ وَأَنتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. And that is, it may be that you dislike a thing while it is good for you, and it may be that you like a thing while it is bad for you. Allah knows all things and you know not. This explains the ultimate love of Allah for his servant. Just like a mother wouldn't give a child a brand of fire, even though the child cries for it, such is the nature of some prayers. If Allah knows that our request is not the best for us, he may not give us. One should not then conclude that his prayer has been rejected. In conclusion, Allah Khalifatul Masih 5, Allah Mirza Masroor Ahmad, Allah Lord Allah Mirza Aziz, has emphasized the condition of acceptance of prayer in his Friday sermon rendered on June 15, 2012. He enumerated the points mentioned by Prophet Messiah about the acceptance of prayer, and he said, fortunate are those who understand the philosophy of acceptance of prayer and supplicate earnestly and profoundly, with full belief and trust in the existence of God Almighty, who has the power to accept prayers. The only way to seek help or guidance from Allah the Almighty or to attain God's favor is for one to supplicate with all given faculties and energies and concentrate in earnest towards Allah. It is our experience that Allah the Almighty accepts such prayers or guides the one who supplicates if the prayer cannot be accepted, and grant him contentment of the heart on the resolution of his prayer. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our prayers, and may he grant us the blessings of this blessed month of Ramadan. Rabbana atina fid dunya hasana wa fil akhirati hasana wa qina adhaban nar. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.